Hey guys, welcome to another really thriving mall episode. We're heading to the southwestern section of the Chicago Metro to Joliet. It's a far drive from the heart of downtown Chicago, taking Interstate 55 from the tri-state. It takes a good half hour, 21 miles on a non-peak period. Let's take a peek inside. Today we're in the Louis Joliet Mall in Joliet, Illinois. This mall has been open since 1978 to a relatively modest two department stores, a Sears and a Marshall Fields. A year later, a third opened with Bergner Weiss. I've heard of Bergner's, but never Bergner Weiss. Let me know if there is any similarity to both these retailers. Let me know in the comments section below. The mall is fairly modest in size. It looks much bigger on the outside, and was surprised that there wasn't a second level. But in my opinion, sometimes having only one level makes it easier to navigate the property and see all the stores in a reasonable amount of time with less walking. The mall nearly got destroyed when the Plainfield tornado in 1990 came within a stone's throw from the southwest entrance. Thank God no damage or injuries occurred to the mall or the Pardons inside. Unfortunately, there were 353 injuries and 29 fatalities all around the Chicago area from the tornado. For something I didn't know, there was another mall a while back that played competition for Louis Joliet. It was the Jefferson Square Mall, only 3 miles away, and that mall had a modest 65 stores, and there were many repeat stores in both mall locations like Musicaland, Stewart's, and Printer's Ink, just to name a few. The Weebles closed at the Jefferson location in 1987, and many of these stores either went to Louis Joliet or closed. Menards eventually moved in as an anchor to replace the Weebles. But unfortunately, a few years later, Menards closed their entrance to the mall, which sped up the closures and eventual death of the entire East Wing, which was kind of sad. Here's a little bit of a background of new stores that opened and closed in the time frame from beginning to end. In September of 1992, Best Buy, which located outside of the mall, opened for the first time. It is connected to Value City Furniture, and in 1994, a Super 8 motel was built northeast of JCPenney's. 3 years later, in 1997, a Hampton Inn and Motel 6 opened northwest of Super 8. Linens and Things opened outside of the mall in 1999, but closed in 2008 when the chain went bankrupt. It was replaced by Ashley Furniture in 2010. In 2002, a flagship Turk Furniture opened on the west side. Jefferson Square ultimately closed around 2002 and was demolished in 2004 for Menards and Walmart, both which opened in 2007. Marshall Field's store was officially renamed Macy's on September 9th, 2006. General Cinema Theaters opened in 1994 with 3 screens. It became Silver Cinemas in 1990, and it featured more screens. It closed in July 2008, and Cinemark opened in its place on May 8, 2009. After visiting, I can say for certain, compared to other properties I visited, like Stratford Square, which has a similar exposed wood ceiling, or Fox Valley Mall, this one by far is the most successful and has the most visitors and is the most lively overall. I was pleasantly surprised of how healthy this property is and hope it continues to succeed in the future and beyond. The current owner of the mall property is Starwood Capital Group, and it was developed by Momart Development Group and was previously owned by the Westfield Group from 2003 and was renamed Westfield Shopping Town Louis Joliet. I'm glad they removed the Shopping Town name soon after because Westfield Shopping Town Louis Joliet just doesn't roll off the tongue very well. Just try to say it really fast. Westfield Shopping Town Louis Joliet. So here we're coming into the food court. It has your typical dining chains that a typical mall has, nothing too special there. But it's nice to see it full, and based on the sign going in, it looks like it has been through some sprucing up. The mall went through its first major renovation in 1995. There's not a lot of information looking up regarding the changes made during the renovation, so if anybody knows anything, let me know in the comments section below. These cubular-like structures are really cool. They almost look like they could be something that lights up in the evening. Hope you enjoyed this Thriving Mall episode. If you have any questions or comments, let me know in the comments section below. And don't forget to subscribe and leave a like. And stay tuned for the next episode. Thanks, guys.